From this video, we are going to see about power transistors. So this is a second chapter of module 1. So in the first chapter of module 1, we studied about various power electronic devices. So we studied about the classification of power electronic devices, that is a power diode, thyristors. Next we saw about the power transistor. We saw about the symbol, structure of each and every power electronic devices in the first chapter of first module. Now this is the second chapter of first module, that is power transistor. First we'll see what is a power transistor. So in the introduction part, we are going to see about power transistors. So we know that a power transistor, it is going to perform control turn on and turn off operation. Basically, a power transistor, it works as a switch. So we know that the power transistor, the switching speed of a power transistor, it is higher than that of a thyristor. So as a definition, understand, power transistor, it is nothing but performing the control turn on and turn off operation, means it is basically a switching action, it has been performed. So the speed of the power transistor, it is higher than that of a thyristor. Now power transistors are classified into 5 types, that is BJT. BJT is nothing but a bipolar junction transistor. Metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, that is nothing but our MOSFET. Next, third one is IGBT. IGBT, it is nothing but insulated gate bipolar transistor. Next, the fourth one is SIT, that is static induction transistor. Next, the fifth one is CoolMOS. So we have seen the symbol, structure and the characteristic of each of these transistors in the first chapter of our module 1. In this chapter, we are going to see about the steady state characteristics and the switching characteristics of each of the transistors. Now before going to that, understand what is a BJT, what are the characteristic features of the BJT. So we know that a BJT, it is nothing but a bipolar junction transistor. BJT, it has 3 terminals. Coming to the terminals, so that is emitter, base and a collector are the terminals of BJT. BJT has a 3 layers, that is N layer, P layer and an N layer or PNP. So understand, so if I tell about the terminals of BJT is emitter, base and collector. Next, coming to the layers, it has a 3 layers. So the layers can be an N layer, P layer and an N layer that forms an NPN transistor, or it can be an PNNP and thus forms the PNP transistor. So as a whole, we say that BJT, it is a 3 terminal, 3 layer, 2 junction the junctions are collector base junction and then other junction is base emitter junction. So these are the 2 junctions of BJT. So if I say that a BJT as a whole, it has a 3 terminal, 3 layer, 2 junction device. So coming to the symbol, so we have a 2 types of BJT, one is an NPN and other is an PNP transistor. Now depending on that, we are going to write the symbol of NPN and the PNP transistor. So here you can see that this terminal, it is a base terminal. Next above you have a collector, next is an emitter. The arrow here, it indicates an emitter. If the arrow is outside or it is towards the emitter layer, then it is an NPN transistor. So if the arrow is towards inside, then we say it as an PNP transistor. This is the base terminal, this is a collector terminal and this is the emitter terminal. And if the arrow mark it is inside, then we say it as a PNP transistor. Now coming to the second one, that is a MOSFET. So MOSFET, we know that it is a metal oxide field semiconductor field effect transistor. So coming to the MOSFET, we know that a MOSFET, it is a voltage control device. MOSFET, it is of two types. One is an N-channel MOSFET and other is a P-channel MOSFET. So now depending on that, we have the two symbols, that is for an N-channel and other thing is for the P-channel. So the terminals of MOSFET is, it is a three terminal, that is gate, drain and source. Gate, drain and source. So we'll see the symbol. Now again, the symbol is a matter here. The arrow mark here, if it is inside, then it indicates and it is an N channel. Now if the arrow mark is outside, then it is called as an P channel. So this is my P channel MOSFET. So MOSFET, it is a voltage control device, whereas a BJT, it is a current control device. Now MOSFET, again it has a three terminals, gate, drain and source. There are two types of MOSFET, one is an N-channel MOSFET and other is the P-channel MOSFET. Next is IGBT, third one is IGBT. IGBT, it is nothing but an insulated gate bipolar transistor. As the name itself indicates, IGBT, it is a combination of BJT and MOSFET. It is a combination of BJT and MOSFET. So IGBT, it has a three terminals, that is gate, collector and emitter. So it has a three terminals, gate, collector and the emitter. The symbol is here, you have a gate and next we have a collector here and next we have an emitter here. The arrow mark, it is always towards the emitter side. Next, coming to the SIT, the fourth one is SIT, that is a static induction transistor. We know that a static induction transistor, it is a very high speed. Switching speed is very high when compared to all the other thyristors. Here the switching speed, that is turn on and turn off time, is very less, that is around 0.25 to 0.35 microsecond. The 0.25 microseconds to 0.35 microseconds, it is a turn on and turn off time, which is nothing but the switching speed. Here it is high. Coming to the terminals and the symbol, so here SIT, it has a three symbols, that is gate, source and drain. So we'll see the symbol of SIT. So this is my gate, this is drain and this is my source. Your arrow mark, it is marked to the source side. So I'll just quickly revise it again. So we are seeing the second chapter of the module 1 of power electronics. So here we are going to study about the steady state and the steady state characteristics and the switching characteristics of power transistors. First we'll see what is meant by a power transistor. A power transistor, it is a control turn on and a turn off operation it is being performed. Basically it is called as a switch. The power transistor speed, it is very high when compared to the thyristor. It is classified into five types. One is first one is a BJT. So we have seen the terminals of BJT and the symbol of BJT. Next is MOSFET. We have two types of a MOSFET. So that is an N channel and the P channel. As I already told, MOSFET, it is a voltage control device, whereas in BJT it is a current control device. Next is IGBT. IGBT, it is a combination of BJT and MOSFET. So the gap here indicates if there is an oxide layer, that is an SiO2 layer is present. Next, the fourth one is SiT. As I already told, SiT, it is an high speed device. High speed switching speed is very large here. So the turn on and the turn off time, it is very less. It is around 0.25 to 0.35 microsecond, and this is a symbol of SiT. Next, coming to CoolMOS, the last one, it is CoolMOS. CoolMOS, it is a very high voltage power MOSFET. The advantage of this is the CoolMOS, it reduces the on state resistance. It is going to reduce the on state resistance. It is same as that of the MOSFET, but it is used for high voltage applications. So, and it is very rarely used. It is used in an industries. So this is the introduction of power transistors. So in the introduction part, we studied what is a power transistor, definition of a power transistor. Next, we seen about the classification of a power transistor. In that, we have five types. In those five types, we have seen the terminals, symbol of each of the transistor. Thank you.